Representative, what do you think of the Sheila Simon pick that the governor's been floating?
Well, if the idea for the governor is to try to, I guess, bring support from downstate, obviously Sheila Simon would be a good pick in reference to that. I've met her a couple of times. I know she's a good person, works very hard, probably supports a number of things that the governor is in support of. So I think in that respect, it'd be a good choice for the governor. But I'm certainly reminded that the governor doesn't choose who his lieutenant governor is. It's left up to the state central committee. Yesterday, members of the Black Caucus and the Downstate Caucus stood up in support of Representative Art Turner, that he would be a good choice. I mean, in terms of experience, how can you beat 30 years of legislative experience? Nobody has 30 years of legislative experience other than Art Turner. So if that's a criteria, having someone that's been a part of this process, knows and understands this process inside and out, then Art Turner obviously is the best choice to be the next lieutenant governor of the state of Illinois.
Do you think the state central committee should defer to the governor's pick in this situation, or no?
Not at all, because currently, state law says that the governor and lieutenant governor run independently of one another. They don't run together. If this were a case where they run together and something happened to a lieutenant governor's candidate, of course the governor should be allowed to pick who that person is. But currently, that's not the way this system is set up. And this system is set up so that they run independently of one another, and that the state central committee has the obligation to choose who the next lieutenant governor candidate would be. And in my mind, the person that gives the governor the greatest opportunity to win in November, and that's what's important here, winning in November, I think that person is our turn.
What are you going to say about the governor's leadership within the party and his ability to get things done if the person he wants as his running mate isn't chosen?
Well, again, beyond whoever he picks, we can't throw, as they say, throw the baby out with the bathwater. There are still things that need to get done here. We're still trying to look at revenue enhancements here. There's still a number of things that we need to be done. That need to be done. We need to work harder on making sure that the millions of dollars of contracts that come out of the state of Illinois have minority goals on it. And we've seen examples where, in the past, that has not happened. So there are a lot of things that the governor still needs to work on. And without regard to who his pick is, he still needs to work on those things.
But I guess my question is, would it make it harder for him to get things done if he is seen as somebody who can't even get his own running mate chosen?
Not in my mind. I mean, this is all subjective. Again, if it were up to, or if our laws presented itself so the governor could choose, and he put his choice up there, fine, that'd be it. But currently, that's not the case here, and these things are all subjective here. And again, we're talking about moving beyond certain benchmarks. So once that person is chosen, governor successful in his next election, whoever that lieutenant governor is, there's still work to be done here, and we have to get past that election and continue to do what's good here for people in the state of Illinois.
Is this situation likely, no matter who ends up actually getting the lieutenant governor nomination, is it likely to weaken the ticket? Are people going to be upset and not work so hard in the fall?
Well, that's entirely up to the governor and his choice, and the choice that's made by the Central Committee to get out there and hit the stump. One thing you can say about Representative Turner is that he's proven himself to be able to do that. He got out there, traveled across the state of Illinois, galvanized hundreds of thousands of voters in support of his candidacy. So he's proven that he can indeed do that. So if people decide not to support because of the choice, I can understand that, but certainly we sometimes have to look at the bigger pictures here. And whoever the state central committee selects to be the governor's choice, that's who they selected, and we'll have to move forward beyond that.
If the state central committee decides not to pick Art Turner, will you still be supporting the governor and lieutenant governor in the fall?
Well, when I think about the other choice, and that is on the Republican side, Senator Brady, someone who I don't think appreciates the role of minorities in government, doesn't, in my opinion, has not shown himself to want to work to enhance minorities here in the state. When I think about that, that's enough to motivate me to work hard on behalf of the Democratic ticket in the state of Illinois. And that's where we really need to be focusing our time. So while this is a process to come up with an individual to be the next lieutenant governor's candidate, whoever that person is, we still need to galvanize around and making sure that the Republicans don't win that seat in November.
Okay. Thank you.